wrist right here, okay? I've heard a couple different things with the wrist, guys. I like to grab it like this. I've heard you should never grab it like that. You should always grab it like this. So if they want to break it, they have to bring your arm out. Really, whatever works for you guys, we can go there or there. So what I'm going to do here, guys, same thing, hand on the top of the head, wrist here, and I'm going to get them to step forward with whichever foot I want to attack. So in my case, I'm going to attack his right foot. So I'm going to come here. It's going to be a pull and circle, and I'm going to get him to step there, just like that. You guys see that motion? I come here, wrist comes down, head comes with it, head moves down, circle, right there, okay? Now, you can really do a low single, guys, off any attack that kind of gets his leg to step, or if you can time it right, where as soon as he steps, you're going for it, that works. So you can also do it here, just from kind of double overs, you just pull. All right, so for the low single, we'll pull him, get him to step. Now, the biggest thing here, guys, is our level change to start out with. So when I'm doing my level change for low single, guys, I'm dropping just about as low as I can go. All right, while still being in a good position. So I'm dropping down hard here and just this position, guys, basic level change. Now, when I hit my low single, guys, there are a couple key points that I want to remember, especially when teaching it. So we come in here, the first thing is we're trapping the foot. Now what I like to do, guys, just like every pull that we do, whether it's a collar tie, an overhook on the arm, it's gonna be that same movement. We're going right at his heel, and I actually like, guys, to put my forearm, the side of my forearm, is kinda still on his foot. It could also be on the mat, but I like to get a cup here, get my forearm kinda right on the outside of his foot here. So I'm there, all right? Now the biggest thing that I've seen, guys, for a couple of you that I've seen do this so far since I've been here, is when we attack here, a lot of you guys are coming here, all right? So your head is outside the knee, and that's not really the best form, guys, in my opinion, because what'll happen there, especially if you guys start to get older, you start to wrestle more experienced guys, if I come down here, I'm already giving him a corner, all right? To get behind, we're gonna create a scramble, we're gonna have all sorts of problems, okay? So what I like to do, guys, not with my face, but right with the dome of your head, okay? Right on this part of your head, this is the hardest part of your head, guys, all right? And you guys are gonna be fine if you use that as an attack, right? We're not headbutting, obviously, but that's where guys headbutt, because that's the hardest part of your head. So I like to put that part of my head, turn this way, right kinda in that muscle right there above his knee, okay? All right? So we're gonna aim this part of our head right there on the inside of his knee. At the same time, we're hooking this here, all right? And we're gonna get him to come down just like that. Now, one thing too, guys, if we're aiming for that point, it's okay too to stand up on your feet. It's not bad either if I'm in here. All right, this happens a lot too, and this isn't really terrible for him, okay? But ideally, I wanna get this part of my head, the dome of my head, right above, and I'm inside of his knee. All right, that's where my attack should be. So from there, we'll go over it real quick. I get him to step with that leg. Your sit out leg is already forward. Yep, just rotate here real quick. So come here, level change hard, guys. Come in, head right here. I'm grasping here. Now this other hand, guys, if you actually hit this right, if you hit it hard and time it well, he, more often than not, is just gonna fall right there. But sometimes that's not enough, right? Maybe he has better balance. Maybe your timing is a little bit off. So this rear hand, guys, this is gonna follow up by tapping his knee right there, okay? So what that's gonna do, if I'm here and I get it and that's not enough, I'm gonna tap his knee. I'm gonna take out his other leg there, okay? And that's basically it, guys. We're coming here. So I'll get the level change, drop to this knee, head right here. This foot is also gonna follow here, okay? So at the same time this hand comes around, this foot is also gonna follow. And one thing that's gonna do, guys, if anything, it's gonna keep our balance so we're not falling here, okay? So here, follow, and I'm covering him, okay? So real quick, a little bit faster. here, I'm down, and I'm circling up just like that, okay? Get here, you can cover up, just like that, okay? Do you guys have any questions? It's pretty straightforward, guys, not too difficult.